We are in the fastest period of technological change and innovation in the whole history of human civilization.
Technological breakthroughs such as cloud compute and AI have helped us cure disease, reform education, and revolutionize the way we generate food and energy. But this profound change needs to be navigated carefully and responsibly.
AI is extremely different from other technologies that we've seen. How quickly it can scale. It has the potential to really transform society in really meaningful ways.
The government decided to give every citizen a digital ID, and then the services from both private and public sector could be linked through digital ID.
The role of technology has been moving to really thinking about transforming our core pillars of society. I think we have to have a framework or almost a protocol with which we build the next generation of companies with AI. And that, I almost think, is a self-regulatory framework for entrepreneurs and investors. Here's the guardrails. I do hope that not only are the governments across the world thinking about, well, how do we regulate AI, that they're also thinking about how do we adopt AI.
When you go online, you also have to streamline, because if you just automatize a horrible bureaucracy, then you get an automatized horrible bureaucracy. We only have 100 years on this planet, not to be wasted in government offices.
When you think about all the things that technology can unlock, that can't happen without it being stewarded well. And that needs to be a partnership. Government is there to understand what people want. And that needs to be translated back into companies so that we can build the technology that helps unlock all of that.
The United Kingdom stands at the forefront of this new technological revolution and possesses the assets and potential for breakthroughs. To secure our future, we must transcend outdated ideologies and embrace a radical new policy agenda centered around science and technology.
When it comes to AI, we need to innovate for equity as much as we innovate for novelty. And so what that means is really government and technologists working together to set up the common infrastructure that we need to ensure that the technology benefits everyone.
For example, imagine we started using AI without properly vetting it and training it in making healthcare decisions for people. Well, that's just simply dangerous.
It's never about technology. It's always about permissive legislation, which will also try to distribute technology fairly.
It is a very exciting time, but it will be a difficult time for those who don't keep up with it. And this country is actually in a particularly strong position to lead the change.
This truly is about abundance and prosperity for each nation, inclusive learning, inclusive healthcare, and having that mindset in the way we bring AI to life.
It has the ability to transform the way we treat diseases. We're able to predict rainfall within 90 minutes of precision and notify people.
Once we have a common framework, a common protocol for how to build these next generation companies with AI, that we will create a prosperous world with it in which everybody can be their best.
With science and technology as our new national purpose, we have the opportunity to innovate and thrive amidst increasing technological change. It requires us to reimagine the state so that it is more strategic, and it also requires a cross-party consensus, rising above political differences and ensuring a sustainable future for generations to come.
If you could choose when to be alive, most of us would choose now. We have thought of ourselves as politicians, economists, historians, scientists, business people. The great challenge in this decade is to get your mind around all of those things, because they're all interacting with each other, and to make sure that we come out in front.